While Tom Brady's future remains in limbo, the rumor mill continues to turn. And according to ESPN's Jeff Darlington, at least 8 teams are monitoring Brady as he prepares to become an unrestricted free agent. And 4 of those teams would, quote, sign him right now. So, Shannon, do you believe this?
Sure. Why only 4, though? Why not all 8? Let me ask you a question, Jenny. Of that 4, how many of them named New England Patriots? Because that was important. Hey, that wasn't important, Jenny.
Okay. You got a cold?
You know, a little cold, a little chilly. I'm just trying to figure it out.
It's cold in here.
There are 4 teams that, if any of them name the New England Patriots.
Absolutely not.
Okay, then. Mm-hmm. So, but we need to stop this notion.
No, we need to start it.
Let me ask you a question. Of the teams that are interested in Amari Cooper, should he hit the mark, are they willing to sign him right now? Yes. Byron Jones, are they willing to sign him? So this notion about this being unique to Tom Brady, if those guys have identified a player, be it a D lineman, O lineman, linebacker, doesn't matter the position. If a team has identified that guy, they would sign him right now. But they got to wait until the 18th, right, Skip Bayless? Mm-hmm. So they're trying to make this all unique. Oh, they would sign Tom Brady tomorrow. And they would sign Byron Jones. They would sign Amari Cooper. They would Jadeveon Clowney. He going to be on the market. Mm. You think a team would sign Jadeveon Clowney right now, Skip Bayless? Well, I believe they would. Mm. So this is not unique to Tom Brady. Mm, yes, and we need to stop making things about, oh, Tom. Tom ain't got nothing on lock. Mm. He got 4 teams, maybe 4 teams held hostage. Mm. Other than that, it's going to be business as usual.
He's got you on lock right here, right now. The great Shannon Sharp about 20, 25 minutes ago on this very television show.
What I say?
He said that Tom Brady fell off the cliff last year. That was your conclusion, he fell off the cliff. So 4 teams are vehemently disagreeing with the Hall of Famer Shannon Sharp if this is true. I don't think it's true because I believe there are 10 or 12 teams on hair trigger who would sign him if it were legal to. Right here in the next hour. If you said he's open for bids in the next hour, I believe 10 to 12 teams would bid for him. And I gave you 13 last week, and I think some are just laying in the weeds. Now, the weeds teams right now are like Bears, Colts, Bucks, maybe even Giants. Laying in weeds.
Yeah.
They're laying in the weeds, and they would jump right into the fray opportunity.
No.
But right now, there are the obvious ones, such as the Chargers and the Titans and the Raiders. Mm-hmm. And then I'm not sure who that fourth. It might even be the 49ers be the most obvious team.
I'm talking about, hold on.
And I didn't even mention my Dallas Cowboys, who are still out there with a big problem, a quandary at quarterback.
If it's not about the money, the team that you're with aren't one of the 4 teams, not one of the 8. See, I believe Seattle would like to keep Jadeveon Clowney, but it's going to be out of, the term price point. You know, it's out of their price point.
Why do we have to keep talking about Jadeveon Clowney when we're talking about the GOAT hitting the market?
Because what I'm saying is what Jeff Darlington is saying. Mm. These are 4 teams that will sign Tom Brady right now. There are 4 teams that will sign any free agent that they're interested in right now. So there's nothing unique about that.
Yes, there is, because you just said he fell off the cliff. You're telling me that Bill Belichick is signaling the league, I'm finished with him, you should all be finished.
Bill Belichick is saying, I do not believe Tom Brady is the same guy. Therefore, I'm perfectly comfortable. Now, that doesn't mean you shouldn't, but I'm saying based on my standard, I'm the GOAT coach.
Okay.
Now, see, you love to give Tom Brady great deference when it comes to quarterbacking because you say he the GOAT. Well, Coach Belichick is the GOAT of coaches. Don't do that. So, in other words, he says, based on what I've seen in the games and at practice, he's not the same. And I'm perfectly fine if he were to go elsewhere.
Is he really saying that? Because you said that 2 years ago he had earned the right to go forward without Tom Brady, no matter what shape Tom Brady is, no matter what level of decline he's in. What if it's just about Bill Belichick saying, I don't care how good he is, I want to do it solo?
I don't believe he believes he's still good. I believe Coach Belichick believes he's good. I don't believe Coach Belichick believes that he's great. Therefore, Coach Belichick says, you know what? He believes this. that he can find someone just as good as Tom Brady is now. Not as great as Tom Brady was, but maybe as good as Tom Brady is now and can get to that same level. With that great defense I got, look at that, what I had. A defense that only gave up 14 points. And if we gave up three more than that, we lost the game. Come on, Jenny.
So wait a second. You just said that Bill Belichick still thinks Tom is good, but Shannon Sharp thinks he fell off the cliff.
No. I'm just going by what, look, I said it from day one. All the pro football folks, they kept telling you and you bought into it. I said, he's not the same. He's not the same. So because if he was the same, he started the season the first 3 weeks, he was number one. So if he was the same guy, he should have finished the season number one. And not 19th in QBR, not 27th in completion percentage, behind Mitchell Trubisky.
But who conducted the drive to secure the two seed in the AFC? Tom Brady did in the fourth quarter.
The same guy that threw the pick six that lost him the game in the divisional, in the wild card round. That's the same guy. Or in the two different Tom Brady.
What if you'd given that beat up, battered, declining team 2 weeks off? What if you had 2 weeks off? Would that not have been gold for
them? They
got
2 weeks off during the Super Bowl against the Rams, and he played bad.
Really? He conducted the game-winning drive in a defensive struggle.
I just want to make sure you understand. I just want to make sure I'm hearing you correctly. Over four quarters, it only cut, so just a drive. So what about the other three quarters? But all the other drives.
What about the previous two playoff games that year?
He my homeboy.
Was special, to use your word. He was special.
What about my homeboy? My homeboy.
He lost and Tom Brady.
No. But I told you, I said he going to get revenge. And then went to the house that Tom built and took him down.
Shannon, I told you, Tom Brady's going to hit the market at 12:01 on March the 16th, 12:01 a.m. Eastern time, and it's going to be Brady Mania. And I believe that the bidding war will encompass up to a dozen teams.
Well, you know what? I like doing hypothetical sometimes. Let's just say, for the sake of argument, Patrick Mahomeboy and Tom Brady both hit the market. Who is in high demand? If he the GOAT, if he's what you said he is, who's in high demand? Mahomeboy or Brady?
It'd be close call.
It ain't gonna close. Close to who?
Well, the one guy has won six Super Bowls to one guy who won one. And you said it was on a lucky 3rd-and-15 conversion.
Right? I know you're not talking about luck. I know you're not talking about luck. The guy that the whole thing, this whole dynasty started because of robbery, the Tuck rule, the whole thing. And then what you call him, gifted him a trophy. Gifted him a trophy. Pete Carroll gifted him one.
Gave away.
Yeah.
So Shannon Sharp says four teams who would sign him tomorrow are insane. They're dead wrong. Am I right? And I'm saying that Michael Jordan in 1998 just hit the market. That's what's happening.
Michael Jordan hit the market at 35, not at 43. Because we remember what Michael was at 40, Jenny, in Washington. I remember, Skip.
He was at the end of his prime in 1998. I was there. And if it's the equivalent of that guy hitting the open market in the NBA, and everybody saying, seriously? Because they're saying seriously.
First of all, Tom Brady is not at Tom Brady. There's no part of my prime that should be mentioned with Tom Brady. Unless he eating prime rib. That's the only prime that Tom Brady should be mentioned with.
One thing he would not eat.
Probably not. I don't know if that's on the pliability.
Nah, I don't eat no prime rib either. Too fatty.
Really?
Nah.
Well,
I guess I know who does eat it, Skip.
I got to learn a lot around you guys. This is interesting, the thing about Chargers, Raiders, 49ers all play the Patriots next year.
Yep.
Ooh, how about that?
Coach Belichick said, I sure hope he go there. I hope he go to one of them teams, because I'm going to show you what y'all should have been doing all along. Coach Belichick said, I'm going to show you how you.